So hey guys, welcome to our Python for Beginners series. In this video, I'm going to introduce lists in Python. So what are lists in Python? Lists are just type of data, just like integers and strings. Now you quite know what are lists, but why are they used? Just like we use our shopping list, list is used to store list of items. It can be anything. It can be list of numbers, it can be list of cars, it can be list of food and anything that you can imagine. So in nutshell, list is used to multiple items in a single variable. Now let's write our first program that uses list. Before you move further, please make sure that you hit the subscribe button so I can do more work to make more videos for you related to design and code. So without wasting of time, let's get started. Now let's start coding. First, we have to open our Python text editor. Here I'm using PyCharm, which works very well. So let's open it. Now let's see how we can define a list. To define a list, let's first add a comment so we can understand what concept I'm telling right now. So let's add a comment to define a list. Now to define a list, first you have to type a variable name. For example, here I'm using num. You can use any variable name that you want. Then you have to type equal to sign. Then you have to type a special symbol, which is open square brackets. This is used to define a list. In this open square bracket, you have to type elements or items that you want to store in this list. For example, I want to store odd numbers. So I can simply say 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, right? So congratulations, our first list is defined. Now let's print this list. I hope you know this print function, print num. Now here you can see, here is our output, 1, 3, 5 and 7 and 9, which is list as we defined. Now please let me explain how this works. In line number 2, we simply say, hey Python, I defined a list using open square brackets, which contains 5 elements. In third line, I simply printed num variable, right? Now you're thinking, okay, we understood that we can use integers numbers in a list, but what about strings and other data types? You can use any data type that you want. Let me show you how. Let's start with strings. Let's take a variable called name. In this variable, I want to store some name. Let's take my name, which is Devgar. It's a Devgar. Let's take second, the Elon Musk. The third, let's take Sakshi. And let's take last but not the least, Warren Buffett. Right? So I took 4 name. Now again print this list using print function. I'm commenting this out, so you should not confuse between this output and that output. Alt R. Yeah. So here you can see is our output, which means we can use numbers also and strings also. Now you're thinking, okay, we can use any type of data, but can we use all data types together, not separately like this? Yes, you can. Let me show you how. Let's take a variable name mix. So I can say mix, again square brackets. Now let's take a first name, I will take will be Steve Jobs. Now let's take our integer, positive integer, for example 78. Now let's take a boolean, for example true and false. Here I'm taking true. Now let's take a negative number, for example minus 62. Now let's take a decimal number, for example 1.5, right? So here is our list. Let's again print the statement, list print mix, again comment. Now here you can see our list is printed as we defined here, right? If some of you know programming languages C and C++, you surely encounter arrays. So fact is that lists are similar to arrays, but Python gives you more flexibility. So now you know how to define a list, and we can also do some operation on the list. For example, we was working on this mixed list, right? Now I forgot to add an item at the end of this list. Now I want to add it without changing from here. Can we do it? Yes, we can. Let me show you how. First, you have to type the variable name or list name that you want to perform action on. For example, here's mix. We are dealing with mix here, right? So just type mix. Then we have to use dot notation, which is very common in Python for applying methods. Now we have to type the name of the method. Here we will use method name called append. This will insert an element at the end of the list. In this bracket, you have to type the data that you want to insert. For example, is true, right? Now it is no false, so I want to insert a false also. Why should we let false? Now let's check this program. Again we're using print function. Yes. Oh, capital case. Now here you can see in first list there was no false, but after applying the append method here is false at the end of this list. Now we know how to insert element at the end of the list, but now I want to insert in between the list. Can I do it? Yes, we can do it. Let me show you how. For example, here Steve Jobs 78 true, minus 62 1.5 and false. I wanted after 78 there should be a name called Bill Gates. So we can do this by again typing the name of the variable which we want to do action on, his mix, right? Then again dot notation. This time we will not use append, this time we will use insert. Now insert took two arguments, means here was one argument, it will take two arguments. In first argument it will ask at which index it want to be insert a element. For example, you can see here this first, second, third, fourth, fifth and sixth. It is six for us. In programming language it is five, because in programming we use zero index piece. That means we should type here two. I want to insert a data with name Bill Gates. His two is index at which we want to insert item and Bill Gates ever data. Now let's check this program. Print mix. Here you will see the difference. Yeah, you can see here that on this first list, mix list, there was no Bill Gates, but after using insert method here is Bill Gates on third place, right? Now we don't want false statement. Can we remove it without changing from here? We can do it. Let's see it how. So what we can do is, let's commit it out first so there is no confusion. Again type name of the variable which is mix. Now we have to use a method known as pop. So again dot notation then pop. Now what this will do is it will remove the last element from this list. Let's see the output. Again print function then mix. What's the problem? Oh, I forgot to. Yeah, now we can check. Now here you can see that first list there was false element due to this append method, but on second time there's no false because of this pop method, right? Now let's see how we can change and get an element from the list. Let's do it. Now we will not use mixed list again because mixed list is mixing a lot, right? So now we will use a list containing car companies. So let's define it, car companies. Now you know how to define a list, car companies, then again square bracket. Now let's type your favorite cars. For example, my is Tata, then is Ford, then is BMW, then is Audi, then is what is GM, then is Tesla, my favorite, and then is Mahindra. Right now what I want to do is that I only want Tata company to be printed out. Now how I can do this? I can simply say print, simple print function, then type the list name, variable name which is car companies. Now we have to use square brackets. Now in this square bracket we will tell the Python of what index element we want, right? So for example, I want only Tata, right? Tata is on which index? It is on zero index. You remember that lists are zero index based. So that's why I cannot say one, I can say zero for Tata only, right? Now let's check this program. Before checking this program, please comment this out so there's no confusion. Let's run this program. Now you can see here is our output, which is Tata, right? Now my second favorite is, for example, GM. Now I don't want Tata, I only want GM. So GM was in which index? GM is on 0, 1st, 2nd, 3rd and 4th, 4th index, right? So I can simply say not 0 but 4. Now let's check this program. Now you can see here is GM, right? Now my second wish is that I want 3 car companies should be printed from a range. For example, I want car companies to be printed from BMW, Audi and GM. These three are my favorite one now. So I want that these three car companies should be only printed. What I can do is, I can simply say, this comment is print, again car company, same, again square brackets. Now, we will tell the Python the starting range. Starting is from 0, 1, 2, second index, right? So we say 2, then we will use colon. We will use colon to define a range from 2 to what? Here will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. My favorite car was BMW, Audi and GM, right? So here we can say 6. Now let's check this program. Now you can see we get 4 cars, but I only want BMW, Audi and GM. So that's why we will change 6 to 5. Now you can see my favorite cars are printed. This is how we can define a range from which we want items from to the end. I use 5 because when I tell to Python, hey Python, I want element from 1 to 6, it gave me element from 1 to 5. When I say, hey Python, I want element from 2 to 7, so it will give me 2 to 6. So this is the how Python behaves. Now last, my final wish list is that I want to change a car company that I don't like. How I can do it? And can we do it? Yes, we can do anything, right? So let's do it. We can simply say car companies. Now I'm not using print statement again here. Car companies, then you have to type square brackets. In this square bracket, you have to tell the Python of which item you want to replace. For example, pick up a Ford. Here's Ford, right? I want to change Ford from a different car company name. How I can do is, car Ford is on first index. So I can say first index, now equal to, now name of the car company that I want to replace from. So here I will write Kia. Please write any string in double quotes or single quotes only, because it will treat as a string, right? Now let's check this program. Car companies. Let's check after and before using this 26th line. Yeah. Now here you can see, before using this statement, there was Ford, but after using this statement, Ford is replaced from Kia. So this is how we can replace an item from the list, and we also saw how we can access and get an element from the list from range and specified element, right? Now I have understood what is list and why is list, how we can define a list and how we can do operation on the list like replacing, inserting, removing, and how we can get items from the list. If you get some info from this video, then please support me by just giving a like, subscribe and comment. Thank you so much for watching the video. See you next video. Till then, bye and Jai Hind.